going to have a go at a rocky stream, again, tumbling stream. I think to make these effective, you need much more water than I have been showing. I think I've been a bit too cramped before, and I can't really give the sweep. So, wet the paper all over, wet in wet. And I'm using some wet paint straight from the tubes. You don't want it swimming with water. Just enough to soak in to keep it damp until you want to dry it. Okay. Now while that's nice and damp, we're getting a bit of raw sienna. Just here and there in the stream, but I just want to put it on the sky, a bit on the landscape, and just a little bit here and there, reflected in some of the water here. Okay, now while that's nice and wet, now you need a cloth to wipe your brush off. So let's put in some background in there, a bit of blue, nice bluey green. As we get warmer, we'll a bit more yellowy, bluey mix. Baby colours. And with some nice yellowy, ochre-y going over the background here. Right, that probably needs to be a little bit thicker on the back there. Right, okay, so far so good. Let's get this water coming down here. Slightly warmer green there. Right here. And then we can put in some other colours. So we've got to establish a light source really, so I think the dark area is going to be over here. So a bit of burnt umber, a bit of paint grey. Nice and thick. Let's put in a little bit here, a bit of blue. And this is the bank coming across here. Some nice greens in there. Right, I'm going to scrape out some of these rocks here in a minute. But I'm not coming up here. A nice rich dark in here. Mix a bit of red with my blue for these rocks. Right, now with my card, I keep losing bits of my card. Ah, there it is. So much messy. Right, I'll just reclip the paper. I haven't finished the sky yet. I might have to re-wet the sky. Let's just get some in there. Right, so some rocks. I can texture over those. Right, let's go back and finish the sky. That's still a bit damp. I can put in a bit of blue. Just a little blush of blue. Not too fussy, I hope. Right, okay. Just take that excess off there. Right, let that go for a minute. And I'm going to put in some darks here, but I've got to put my... I want to put a tree in there. So a nice, rich colour in there. A green. Oh, a nice dark green. This is the counter change against that lovely light behind. And then a bit on this side here. Right, now I'm going to put in the trunk of this tree. It's a bit greeny grey. Get that bit dark in there on that side. I'll just let that dry. Alright, now I'm going to... Well, that's nicely drying there. Let's get some yellowy, greeny trees. I need to get the brush nice and clean. Want some pure sort of colour. I don't want any darks mixed in with this. Really. So the background leaves. A bit dark on that. Not dark enough. A bit of grey in there. And we'll get some richer dark greens. Catching the under sides of the leaves here, a bit shadowy. Right, let's get a more saturated green there now. So a bit of grey, a bit of umber, a bit of yellow. another bit of a tree in there. Another tree in here. Yeah, sort of impressionist type. Just go off into the distance, right? You can put more blue. Right. Okay, so now we need some bit more dark in there. All shadowy. Alright, that'll have some rigor. Water, something. Oh, I picked up a cough from a friend. He's coughing as he was. So struggling a bit at the moment. So I just put in some trees over here. Yeah, I show some distance, haven't you? Just want to put some shadow on and drag some on the shadow side of these rocks. Oh, okay. Do a bit of stuff here. Not a lot really, just a few warmer trees and use all the height, don't just use a bit of it. A bit dark in there. Not too high below. That's dry, headphones off. Right, now I'm going to dry it down the bottom here so you can put this water in. Now, we've got some nice blue in the sky, so a bit of a light. Right, here we go. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to put some shadow in there, or reflections in the water. Slightly darker. Right, we've got some movement in there. Oh, excuse me. I think a large whiskey and ginger and something might be appropriate for me tonight. I'm just trying to reconcile this. I won't put a figure in. Probably standing on a rock, so have I got anybody standing on a rock on my model? No, not really. So let's just imagine someone. Maybe here. Give him the red, because red sort of sings against the... I'll have him standing. Put in light. Last. Put in there. And some jeans. Mid. See, he looks all right, doesn't he? Making a bit more red. Well, I think he's in scale because he's further into the picture than this tree, so you've got to think of that. Maybe he's still a bit small. Anyway, I'm going to let him go. I'll make his legs a little bit longer, maybe. My body a bit longer. Alright, he looks okay. Well, I'm going to put in some stuff in the rigger. Not a lot, but just need a lot of water when you're doing this. Just to show something going on in here. Right, okay, that's a very simple watercolour. Let's just see that sign. I will be using acrylic soon. when I've done my watercolours, when I've got that out of my system, let's put it in the mouth. And I'll stop coughing. Right, let's put that there. Now I reckon the broom out, do you? Any questions, just leave a comment on the thing. On the sites. Well, there we are, nice bright summery day. Where would that be? Say Wales. Tumbling Stream. We'll call it Tumbling Stream. Tumbling Stream. Don't know if I could really improve that anymore. It's what it is. Right, let's move the camera around. And then we'll, whoops. A bit more, I think. Right, well, that's a square, that's fairly square, I think. Would it be better if we come around there? No, around there. That's it. Right, there's my little figure, standing on a rock. I hope he probably is just a tiny bit too small. I don't know, he's in scale with those trees. This one, we would have to imagine that that's further down. You have to remember that, but the stream, the rocky stream. I'm not too displeased with that. Let's have a, oops, let's go into it and have a look at me man. And I pop. See, the red is a great foil to the greens. It's the only bit of neat red we put in, and that's the light red. There's the tree. Right, all very loosely stated, just an impression. The rocks there coming across the stream, the rocky stream. Right, those rocks look quite realistic, and they're so simple. Have a practice of that. Copy this. It's not a great picture or anything, I'm not saying it is, but it's all good practice. The more you do, the better you get. There's nothing magical about it. It just depends on the work you do. And we all do different things. And I'm discovering the subscribers that are taking the trouble to comment and encourage. Many of you are very, very fine artists indeed and should have your own channel. You know, a lot of respects, you're better at what you do than I am what I do with what I do. But we're all different. But I'm very impressed by some of your work, absolutely impressed. It's superb. And to those that are self-taught as I am, well done. A self-taught artist has a bad teacher, but we get there in the end. Thanks for listening and thanks for watching. Bye-bye.